Hello folks, so this is my XUAV Talon Pro build, or what we refer to as the Mini Talon version 2. So I'll give you a walk around on the parts that I've used on this build. So let's get started. The entire plane is covered with trim laminating film that makes it a lot stronger than stock EPO foam. I've added this blue covering film from Hobbywing to add accent on the plane, some black carbon fiber style stickers to add more highlights on the plane. Underneath, I've added a 5mm laminating film, two layers of it to protect the fuselage during landing. For the nose of the Talon Pro, I cut this foam out before gluing the two halves of the fuselage together, and printed my own nose canopy cover using PETG film. So I printed a few pieces of it. So this is the plain canopy. I also printed the pan tilt canopy. So I'll post the link for these designs. These are available in Timbers, by the way. So I have the Runcam Nano Bardwell Edition FPV cam. This is my front facing camera. So I remove this cover. You'll see the three-way camera switcher. So I intend to use multiple cameras on this build. So one on the pan tilt, and maybe I'll add another one here facing backwards. It could be a Runcam HD. So I have this servo connector for the pan servo. So I'm still thinking if I'll be using a pan tilt setup or just a pan setup on this plane. So on this side, you'll see this 3D printed pitot sub mount. So again, made from PETG. So for my airspeed sensor setup. So to secure the nose canopies, I buried some M3 nylon standoffs and glued it there, so I can just screw these mounts, these canopies into the plane. I used the provided straps for the canopy hatch, also at the back, and installed a piece of tape to help me pull this hatch out. So it could be quite difficult to pull this hatch out if we don't add tape on that part. And at the back of the plane, you'll see a 3D printed skid. So this one, I opted to use TPU, or the flexible filament, to help prevent damage for the rear skid during landings. Motor mount made from PETG material, and here you have the Nimbus 510kb 2814 size motor that came with my fly dream crosswind mini. And I'm using an Aeronaut CAM carbon folding propeller 10x7 size. Then here you can see this 3D printed prop stopper designed by Marky Vale. He posted it in XQV.com. Now for the servos, I'm using the Emax ES09MD. Those are Metal Gear digital servos. For the wing servos, I'm using Hitec HS-5085mg. Those are digital Metal Gear servos. And if you can see, I am running a wire for my Dragon Link Nano RX. So the antenna is poking on both sides of the wing. You might be wondering how will this antenna fit in the box or when I'm storing this plane because of these spoke antennas, but not to worry, you can just pull off these struts and fold them in. On the other wing, I have here the Matek 1.3 GHz video transmitter with singular polarized antenna. This one is RHCP, so right hand circular polarized antenna. So I've got the wires running from the VTX to the wing root. So I've added here the heatsink to provide cooling. So if you can see, the antenna is somewhat flushed into the wings, so don't expect it to add drag like the Dragon Link antenna. This one is 433 MHz, so it's quite a long antenna. So I opted for the RHCP antenna so I can have or can install a side feed kind or type into the wing to reduce drag. I used the MPX 6-pin connector throughout all the wires through these pins. So this is for the video transmitter and servo, and on the other side I've also installed the MPX or multiplex 6-pin connector for the Dragon Link and servos. So I printed this MPX holder. I posted it already in Thingiverse if you want to also use this kind of connectors for your build. And those who are worried that this might get disconnected during flight, to be honest, MPX connectors are really tough or difficult to disconnect. And also we have this screw for the wing clamps to secure the wings from pulling out sidewards. So once you tighten the screw, so there's no way that these wings will be disconnected during flight. Inside the fuse, so again, I've used these tuck straps that came with the package, then added this piece of tape for easy pulling out of the canopy hatch. So you can see here, very big space for your battery pack. And also I got the GPS pack inside this bay because I have nothing else or nowhere else to put this GPS unit. And the XT60 connector that connects the power module to the battery. And also, yeah, this one is your airspeed sensor. You can see the silicone tubes running from the sensor. This goes to this pitot tube. So I brought the wires on the side of the fuselage to make everything a little bit clean. To open this part, so again, you just have to lift this strap a little bit and put it with your hand and pull this tape out. Okay, so here's the power module, a Pixhawk light, and of course a lot of wires running from the servo connections, the camera connections. I have the micro minimum OSD there, the Matek 5-in-1 PDB. So I've installed the PDB here for to facilitate the supplies for the camera and the VTX. And in a Hobbywing 40 amps ESC, that is a flyfun V5 ESC that provides 5 volts 8 amperes supply to the servos of the Pixhawk light. It's my OLED for to display some information from the flight controllers in case I don't want to use the OSD on my goggles or FPV monitor. So I routed the wires for the servo connections that goes to the MPX or the multiplex 6-pin connection. So this goes for both sides. For the battery packs, I'm using my 6S2P9600 milliamp hours pack that I built especially made for this plane. And I might also try to use my 6S3P 50,000 milliamp hours battery pack that I've been using with my 5G Pro Stream Mini. So The 6S3P weighs about 1.2 kilograms and this one weighs about 800 grams. So these are made from 21700 lithium ion cells, and I've just used my spot welder to assemble all of these battery packs for my long range planes.